Wexley.
Jesus, you scared me!
Sorry.
Look, what are you doing here?
I thought I'd check up on you. Why aren't you in bed?
Your student is still here? He's up in your study.
He can let himself out.
I might as well wait up till he's done.
He's not my student anymore. He's teaching now. Bright kid.
What time is it?
It's almost one. Huh. It's after midnight.
So?
So? Happy birthday.
Dad.
Do I ever forget?
Thank you.
25. I can't believe it.
Neither can I. Should we have it now?
It's up to you.
Yes.
You want me to open it?
Let me. Last time you opened a bottle of champagne, you broke a window.
That was a long time ago.
You're lucky.
I resent your bringing it up.
You're lucky you didn't lose an eye.
25!
I feel old.
Oh, you're a kid.
Glasses?
God damn it, I forgot the glasses. Do you want me to go?
Nah.
I hope you enjoy it. I wasn't sure what to get you.
This is the worst champagne I have ever tasted.
I am proud to say I don't know anything about wine. I hate those kind of people who are always talking about vintages.
It's not even champagne.
The bottle was the right shape.
Great Lakes Vineyards. I didn't know they made wine in Wisconsin.
A girl who's drinking from the bottle shouldn't complain. Hey, don't guzzle it. It's an elegant beverage. Sip.
Do you?
No, go ahead.
You sure?
Yeah, it's your birthday.
Happy birthday to me.
What are you going to do on your birthday?
Drink this? Have some.
No. I hope you're not spending your birthday alone.
I'm not alone.
I don't count.
Why not?
I'm your old man. Go out with some friends.
Right.
Your friends aren't taking you out?
No.
Why not?
Because in order for your friends to take you out, you generally have to have friends.
Ah.
It's funny how that works.
You have friends. What about that cute blonde? What was her name?
What?
She lives over on Ellis Avenue. You used to spend every minute together.
Cindy Jacobson?
Cindy Jacobson.
That was in third grade, Dad. Her family moved to Florida in 1983.
Oh. Well, what about Claire?
She's not my friend. She's my sister. And she's in New York. And I don't like her.
Ah. I thought she was coming in.
Not till tomorrow.
My advice, if you find yourself awake late at night, is to sit down and do some mathematics.
Oh, please.
Hey, we can do something together.
No!
Why not?
I can't think of anything worse. You sure you don't want any?
Yeah, sure. You used to love it.
Not anymore.
You knew what a prime number was before you could read.
Well, now I've forgotten.
Don't waste your talent, Catherine.
I knew you'd say something like that.
I realize you've had a difficult time.
Thanks.
That's not an excuse. Don't be lazy.
I haven't been lazy. I've been taking care of you.
Kid, I've seen you. You sleep till noon. You eat junk. You don't work. The dishes pile up in the sink. If you go out, it's to buy magazines. You come back with a stack of magazines that high. I don't know how you read that crap. And those are the good days. Some days you don't get up. You don't get out of bed.
Those are the good days.
Bullshit. Those days are lost. You threw them away, and you'll never know what else you threw away with them. The work you lost. The ideas you didn't have. The discoveries you never made because you were moping in your bed at 4 in the afternoon. You know I'm right.
I've lost a few days.
How many?
I don't know.
I bet you do.
What?
I bet you can.
Knock it off.
Well, do you know or don't you?
I don't.
Of course you do. How many days have you lost?
A month. Around a month.
Exactly.
God damn it.
How many?
33 days.
Exactly. exactly?
I don't know.
Well, be precise, for Christ's sake.
I slept till noon today.
Call it 33 1/4 days.
Yes. All right.
You're kidding.
No.
Amazing number.
It's a depressing fucking number.
Catherine, if every day you say you've lost were a year, it would be a very interesting fucking number.
33 1/4 years is not interesting.
Stop it. You know exactly what I mean.
1,729 weeks.
1,729. Great number. The smallest number expressible as...
the sum of 2 cubes in 2 different ways.
12 cubed plus 1 cube equals 1,729.
And 10 cubed plus 9 cubed. Yes, we've got it. Thank you.
You see? Even your depression is mathematical. Stop moping and get to work. The kind of potential you have.
I haven't done anything good.
You're young. You've got time.
I do?
Yes.
By the time you were my age, you were famous.
By the time I was your age, I had already done my best work.
What about after?
After what?
After you got sick?
What about it?
You couldn't work then.
No. If anything, I was sharper.
Dad.
Hey, I was. It's true. The clarity, that was the amazing. No doubts.
You were happy?
Yeah, I was busy.
Not the same thing.
I don't see the difference. I knew what I wanted to do, and I did it. If I wanted to work a problem all day long, I did it. If I wanted to look for information, secrets, complex and tantalizing messages, I could find them all around me. In the air. In a pile of leaves some neighbor raked together. In box scores in the paper, written in the steam coming up off a cup of coffee, the whole world was talking to me. If I just wanted to close my eyes, sit quietly on the porch, and listen for the messages, I did that. It was wonderful.
How old were you when started?
Mid-20s, 23, 24. Is that what you're worried about?
I've thought about it.
Just getting a year older means nothing, Catherine.
It's not just getting older.
It's me.
I've thought about it.
Really?
How could I not?
Well, if that's what you're worried about, you're not keeping up with the medical literature. There are all kinds of factors. It's not simply something you inherit. Just because I went bug house doesn't mean you will. Hey, listen to me. Life changes fast in your early 20s, and it shakes you up. You're feeling down. It's been a bad week. You had a lousy couple years. No one knows that better than me, but you're going to be okay.
Yeah.
Yes. I promise you. Push yourself. Don't read so many magazines. Sit down and get the machinery going, and I swear to God you'll feel fine. The simple fact that we can talk about this together is a good sign.
A good sign?
Yes.
How could it be a good sign?
Because crazy people don't sit around wondering if they're nuts.
They don't.
Of course not. They've got better things to do. Take it from me. A very good sign that you're crazy is the inability to ask the question, am I crazy?
Even if the answer is yes.
Crazy people don't ask. You see?
Yes.
So if you're asking...
I'm not.
But if you were, it would be a very good sign.
A good sign.
A good sign that you're fine.
Right.
You see, you just gotta think these things through. Now, come on, what do you say? Let's call it a night. some sleep, and then in the morning we
Wait!
Can...
No.
What's the matter?
It doesn't work.
Why not?
It doesn't make sense.
Sure it does.
No.
Where's the problem?
The problem is you are crazy.
What difference does that make?
You admit it. You just told me that you are.
Yes, but it's...
You said a crazy person would never admit that.
Oh, I see.
So?
It's a point.
So how can you admit it?
Well, because I'm also dead, aren't I? Heart
you
failure?
Died a week ago.
Heart failure? Quick. The funeral's tomorrow.
That's why Claire's flying in from New York.
Yes.
You're sitting here. You're giving me advice. You brought me champagne.
Yes.
Which means?
For you?
Yes.
For you, Catherine. My daughter, who I love very much. It could be a bad sign. Sorry. Did I wake you?
What?
Were you asleep?
You scare me, for Christ's sake. What are you doing?
Sorry. I didn't realize it had gotten so late. Well, I'm done for the night.
Good.
Drinking alone?
Yes.
Champagne, no?
Yes.
Celebrating?
No. I just like champagne.
It's festive.
What?
It's festive.
Do you want some?
Sure.
I'm done. You can take the rest with you.
Oh, yeah, no thanks.
Take it, I'm done.
Nah, I shouldn't. I'm driving. Yeah, well, now I can let myself out.
Good.
When should I come back?
Come back?
Yeah, I'm nowhere near finished. Maybe tomorrow?
We have a funeral tomorrow.
Ray, I'm sorry. I was hoping to attend, if that's all right.
Yes?
Well, what about Sunday? Will you be around?
You've had 3 days.
Yeah, I'd love to get some more time in up there.
How much longer do you need?
Like another week? Yeah, at least.
Are you joking?
No.
A week.
Do you know how much stuff there is up there? Yeah, look, I know you don't need anybody in your hair right now. I've gone through the stuff over the last couple of days. It's mostly notebooks. He dated them all, so now that I've got them in order, I don't have to work here. I could take some stuff home, read it, bring it back.
No.
I'll be perfect.
My father wouldn't want anything moved. And I don't want anything to leave this house.
Well, then I should work here. I'll stay out of the way.
You're wasting your time.
Somebody's got to go through your dad's papers.
There's nothing up there. It's garbage.
There are 103 notebooks.
I've looked at those. It's gibberish.
Somebody should read them.
He was crazy.
Yes, but he wrote them.
He was a graphomaniac, Harold. Do you know what that is?
I know. He wrote compulsively. Call me Hal.
There's no connection between the ideas. There's no ideas. It's like a monkey at a typewriter. 103 notebooks full of bullshit.
Make sure that they're bullshit.
I'm sure.
I'm prepared to look at every page. Are you?
No. I'm not crazy.
Yeah, well, I'm gonna be late. Some friends of mine are in this band. They're playing at the bar up in Mercy. Way down the bill. They're probably not going on till like 2 or 2:30, but yeah, I said I'd be there.
imaginary number?
Yeah, it's a math joke. You see why they're way down the bill?
Long drive to see some nerds in a band.
God, I hate it when people say that. This is not that long a drive.
So they are nerds.
Yeah, they're raging geeks, but they're geeks who can dress themselves, hold down a job at a major university. Some of them have switched from glasses to contacts. They play sports, they play in a band, they get laid, surprisingly often. So in that sense, it sort of makes it question a whole set of terms. Nerd, geek, wonk, Dilbert, hasty nerd.
You're in this band, aren't you?
Okay, yes, I play drums. Do you want to come? No, I never sing. I swear to God.
No, thanks.
All right, look, Catherine, Monday, what do you say?
Don't you have a job?
Yeah, I have a full teaching load this quarter, plus my own work.
Plus band practice?
Yeah, I don't have time to do this, but I'm going to. If you'll let me. I loved your dad. I don't believe a mind like his can just shut down. He had lucid moments. He had a lucid year. A whole year 4 years ago.
It wasn't a year. It was more like 9 months.
A school year. He was advising students. I was stalled in my PhD. I was that close to quitting. I met with your dad and he put me on the right track with my research. I owe him.
Sorry.
Look, you're 25, right?
How old are you?
No, it doesn't matter. Listen.
Fuck you! How old are you?
I'm 28, all right? When your father was younger than both of us, he made major contributions to three fields. Algebraic geometry, nonlinear operator theory, and game theory. Most of us never get our heads wrapped around one. He basically invented the mathematical techniques for studying rational behavior. Gave the astrophysicists plenty to work over to, okay?
Don't lecture me.
I'm not. I'm telling you. If I could come up with one tenth of the shit your dad produced, I could write my own ticket to any math department in the country.
Give me your backpack.
What?
Give me your backpack.
Why?
I want to look inside it.
What?
Open it and give it to me.
Oh, come on.
You're not taking anything out of this house.
No, I wouldn't do that.
You're hoping to find something upstairs that you can publish.
What? Yeah.
Then you can write your own ticket.
No, what? It would be under your dad's name. It would be for your dad.
I don't believe you. You have a notebook in that backpack.
What are you talking about?
Give it to me.
I think you're being a little bit paranoid.
Paranoid?
Yeah, maybe a little.
Fuck you, Hal. I know you have one of my notebooks.
You just said there's nothing up there, didn't you? Did you just say that?
Yes.
So what would I take, right?
You're right.
Thank you.
So you don't need to come back.
Please, somebody should know for sure whether there's anything.
I live with him. I spent my life with him. Fed him, talked to him, tried to listen when he talked. Talk to people who weren't there. Watched him shuffling around the house like a ghost, a very smelly ghost. He was filthy. I had to make sure he bathed. My own father.
I'm sorry, I shouldn't have.
After my mother died, it was just me here. I tried to keep him happy no matter what idiotic project he was doing. He used to read all day. He kept demanding more and more books. I took them out of the library by the carload. We had hundreds upstairs. Then I realized he wasn't reading. He believed aliens were sending him messages through the Dewey Decimal numbers on the library books. He was trying to work out the code.
What kind of messages?
Beautiful mathematics, the most elegant proofs. Perfect proofs. Proofs like music.
That sounds good. tragedy, but...
Later, the writing phase. Scribbling 19, 20 hours a day. I ordered him a case of notebooks, and he used every one. I dropped out of school. I'm glad he's dead.
I understand why you'd say that.
Fuck you.
No, you're right. I can't imagine dealing with that. I know you...
You don't know me. I want to be alone. I don't want him around.
Him? He's...
You! I don't want you here.
Why not?
He's dead.
But I'm not.
He's dead. I don't need any protégés around.
Well, there will be others.
What?
You think I'm the only one? People are already working over his stuff. Somebody's gonna read those notebooks.
I'll do it.
No, you...
He's my father. I'll do it.
You can't.
Why not?
You don't have the math? It's all just squiggles on a page. You wouldn't know the good stuff from the junk.
It's all junk.
If there was anything up there, it would be pretty high order. It'd take a professional to recognize it.
I think I could recognize it.
Kathy.
What?
I know your dad taught you some basic stuff, but come on.
You don't think I could do it?
I'm sorry. I know you could. Hey, come on! Give me a break! This isn't an airport.
You can come back tomorrow.
The University Health Service is very good. My mom died a couple years ago. I was pretty broken up. Plus, my work wasn't going that well. I met with a doctor over there for a couple months. It really helped.
I'm fine.
Also, exercise is great. Yeah, I run along the lake a couple mornings a week. It's not too cold yet. If you wanted to come, I could pick you up. We wouldn't have to talk.
No, thanks.
All right, well, I'm going to be late, so...
Okay.
It's like 20 minutes up to the club. Yeah, we go on, we play, we're horrible. But we buy everyone drinks afterwards to make up for it. You're home by 4, 4:30 tops.
Good night.
Good night.
Wait, your coat!
Oh, no, you don't have to, it's fine. I'm an auto mechanic who, after years of greasy work, a hopeless wreck. Turns the ignition and hears a faint cough. I'm not driving yet, but there's cause for optimism. Talking with students helps, so does being outside, eating meals in restaurants, riding buses, all the activities of normal life. Most of all, Kathy. The year she has lost caring for me. I almost wrote wasted. Yet her refusal to let me be institutionalized, her keeping me at home, caring for me herself, has certainly saved my life. Made writing this possible. Made it possible to imagine doing math again. Where does her strength come from? I can never repay her. Today is her birthday. She's 21. I am taking her to dinner. It's dated September 4th. That's tomorrow.
It's today.
You're right. I shouldn't have tried to sneak it out. Tomorrow. It sounds so stupid now. I was gonna wrap it. Happy birthday.
Don't you want to try it on and see if it fits?
I'll put it on later.
If you want to dry your hair, I have a hair dryer. Did you use that conditioner I brought you?
No. Shit, I forgot.
You'll like it. It's my favorite, Katie.
I
want you to try it.
I'll use it next time.
You'll like it. It has jojoba.
What is jojoba?
Something they put in for healthy hair.
Hair is dead.
What?
It's dead tissue. You can't make it healthy.
Whatever. Something that's good for your hair.
What, a chemical?
No, it's organic.
Well, it can be organic and still be a chemical.
I don't know what it is.
Haven't you ever heard of organic chemistry?
It makes my hair look, feel, and smell good. That's the extent of my information about it. You might like it if you decide to use it.
Thanks. I'll try it.
Good. If the dress doesn't fit, we can go downtown and exchange it.
Okay, I'll take you to lunch.
Great. Maybe Sunday, before I go back. Do you need anything?
Like clothes?
Or anything, while I'm here.
Nah, I'm cool.
I thought we'd have some people over tonight, if you're feeling okay.
I'm feeling okay, Claire. Stop saying that.
You don't have any plans?
No!
I ordered some food, wine, beer.
We are burying Dad this afternoon.
I think it'll be all right. Anyone who's been to the funeral and wants to come over for something to eat can. It's the only time I can see any old Chicago friends. It'll be nice. It's a funeral, but we don't have to be completely grim about it, if it's okay with you.
Yeah, sure.
It's been a stressful time. I think it would be good to relax in a low-key way.
She says hi.
Hi, Mitch.
He's really sorry he couldn't come.
Yeah, he's gonna miss all the fun.
He wanted to see you. Sends his love. I said you'll see her soon enough. We're getting married.
Oh, shit!
Yes, we just decided.
Yikes.
Yes.
When?
January. Huh. We're not going to do a huge thing. His folks are gone, too. Just city hall, dinner at our favorite restaurant with our closest friends. And you, of course. I hope you'll be in the wedding.
Yeah, of course.
Congratulations, Claire. I'm really happy for you.
Thanks.
Me, too. We just decided it was time. His job is great. I just got promoted.
Huh.
You will come.
Yeah, sure. January. I mean, I don't have to check my calendar or anything.
Sure. That makes me very happy. How are you?
Okay.
Well, how are you feeling about everything?
About everything.
About Dad.
What about him?
How are you feeling about his death?
Are you all right?
Yes. I am.
Honestly?
Yes!
I think it was the right time. If there ever is a right time. Do you know what you want to do now?
No.
Well, do you want to stay here?
I don't know.
Do you want to go back to school?
I haven't thought about it.
There is a lot to think about. How do you feel?
Physically? Great. Except my hair seems kind of unhealthy. I wish there was something I could do about that.
Oh, come on, Catherine.
What is the point of all these questions?
Katie, some policemen came by while you were in the shower.
Yeah?
They said they were checking up on things here, seeing how everything was this morning.
That was nice.
They said they responded to a call last night and came to the house.
Yeah?
Did you call the police last night?
Yeah.
Why?
I thought the house was being robbed.
But it wasn't.
Now I changed my mind.
First you call 911 with an emergency, and then you hang up on them.
I didn't really want them to come.
So why did you call?
I was trying to get this guy out of the house.
Who?
One of Dad's students.
Dad hasn't had any students in years.
No, he was Dad's student. Now he's a mathematician.
Why was he in the house in the first place?
Well, he's been coming here to look at Dad's notebooks.
In the middle of the night?
It was late. Last night I was waiting for him to finish and I thought he might have been stealing them.
Stealing the notebooks?
Yes. So I told him to go.
Was he stealing them?
Yes! That's why I called the police.
What is this man's name?
Hal.
Harold. Harold Dobbs. The police said you were the only one.
He left before they got here.
With the notebooks.
No! Claire! Don't be stupid! There are over 100 notebooks up there, but he was only stealing one. But he was stealing it so he could give it back to me. So I let him go so he could play with his band on the north side.
His band?
Yeah. It was late. He wanted me to come with him, but I was like, yeah, right.
Is Harold Dobbs your boyfriend?
No!
Are you sleeping with him?
What? No! He's a bad geek!
In a band. A rock band.
No, a marching band. He plays trombone. Yes, a rock band.
Well, what's the name of his band?
How should I know?
Harold Dobbs didn't tell you the name of his rock band?
No. I don't know. Look at the paper. They were playing last night. They do a song called Imaginary Number that doesn't exist.
I'm sorry. I'm just trying to understand. Is Harold Dobbs...
Stop saying
Harold Dobbs. Is this person...
Harold Dobbs exists.
I'm sure he does.
He's a mathematician at the University of Chicago. Call the fucking math department.
Don't get upset. I'm just trying to understand. I mean, if you found some creepy grad student trying to steal some of Dad's papers and you called the police, I'd understand. If you were here partying, drinking with your boyfriend, I'd understand. But the two stories don't go together.
Because you made up the boyfriend story. I was here alone.
Harold Dobbs wasn't here.
No!
drinking champagne with?
With no one. Are you sure?
Yes.
The police said you were abusive.
Yeah.
They said you're lucky they didn't haul you in.
Those guys were assholes, Claire. They wanted me to fill out a report. They wouldn't go away.
Were you abusive?
This one cop kept spitting on me when he talked. It was disgusting.
Did you use the word dickhead?
Oh, I don't know.
Did you tell one cop to go fuck the other cop's mother?
Not with that phrasing.
Did you strike one of them?
They were trying to come in the house.
Oh my God.
I might have pushed them a little.
They said you were either drunk or disturbed.
They wanted to come in here and search
my house.
You called them?
Yes, but I didn't actually want them to come. But then they did come, and then they started walking around acting like they owned the place. Pushing me around, calling me girly, smirking at me, laughing. Those guys were assholes, Claire.
Those guys seem perfectly nice. They were off duty, and they took the time to come back here and check up on you. They were very polite.
Well, people are nicer to you.
Katie, would you like to come to New York?
Yes, I told you, January.
You could come sooner. Stay with us, we have plenty of room. It would be fun.
I don't want to.
Mitch has become an excellent cook. It's like his hobby or something. He buys all sorts of gadgets. Garlic press, olive oil sprayer. Every night it's something new. Delicious, wonderful meals. The other day, he made a vegetarian chili.
What the fuck are you talking about?
Stay with us for a while. It would be fun.
Thanks. I'm okay here.
Chicago is dead. New York is so much more fun, you wouldn't believe it.
The fun thing is really not where my focus is at the moment.
But I think New York will be a really fun, safe place for you.
I don't need a safe place! And I don't want to have any fun! I'm perfectly fine here.
You look tired. I think you could use some downtime.
Downtime?
Katie, please, you've had a very hard time.
I'm perfectly okay.
I think you're upset and exhausted.
I was fine until you got here!
You and... Who is that?
Hey, who's...
Harold Dobbs! Okay? I really don't need this, Claire. I'm fine. I am totally fine. And then you swoop in here with these questions and... Are you okay? And your soothing tone of voice and... Oh, the poor policeman! I think the police can handle themselves. And bagels and bananas and ho-ho-ba and come to New York and vegetarian chili! I mean, it really pisses me off, so just save it!
Hi, I'm Claire, Kevin's sister.
Oh, hi, Hal. Nice to meet you. I hope I'm not too early. I was hoping to get some work done before the...
Yes.
Sure, okay.
That's Harold Dobbs?
Yes.
He's cute.
Oh,
he's a mathematician?
I think you owe me an apology, Claire.
We have a lot of decisions to make. But I shouldn't have tried to start first thing in the morning. I don't want an argument. Maybe Hal would like a bagel.
Thank you.
sister's friends left hours ago. The guys were really pleased to be asked to participate. They worshipped your dad.
It was Claire's idea.
It was good.
The performance of Imaginary Number was sort of moving.
It was a good funeral. Not good.
No. Yeah.
Oh, can you believe how many people showed up?
I was surprised.
I think you would have liked it. Sorry, it's not my place.
No, you're right. Everything was better than I thought.
You look great.
Claire gave it to me.
I like it.
It doesn't really fit.
No, Catherine, it's good.
When do you think they'll leave?
Hard to say. Mathematicians are insane. I was in this conference in Toronto last fall. I'm young, right? I'm in shape. Thought I could hang with the big boys. Wrong? I have never been so exhausted in all my life. 48 straight hours of drinking, partying, drugs, papers, lectures. Yeah, amphetamines mostly. No, I mean, I don't. But some of the older guys, really hooked.
Really?
Yeah, they think they need it.
Why?
They think math's a young man's game. Speed keeps them racing, makes you feel sharp. There's this fear that your creativity peaks around 23, and it's all downhill from there. Once you hit 50, it's all over. Might as well teach high school.
That's what my father thought.
I don't know. Some people stay for a living.
Not many.
Nah, you're right. Real original work, it's all young guys.
Young guys.
Young people.
But it is men, mostly.
There are some women.
Who?
There's a woman at Stanford. Can't remember her name.
Sophie Germain?
Yeah. I think I've seen her at meetings. I just don't think I've met her.
She was born in Paris in 1776.
Yeah, so I've definitely never met her.
She was trapped in her house. The French Revolution was going on. The terror. She had to stay inside for safety, so she passed the time reading in her father's study. The Greeks. Later, she tried to get a real education, but the schools didn't allow women. So she wrote letters. She wrote to Gauss. She used a man's name. Antoine Auguste Leblanc. She sent him some proofs involving a certain kind of prime number. Important work. He was delighted to correspond with such a brilliant young man. Dad gave me a book about her.
I'm stupid. Sophie Germain, of course.
You know her?
Germain Primes?
Right.
They're famous, yeah. Double them and add one, and you get another prime. Like two. Two is prime, doubled plus one is five. Also prime.
Right. Or 92,305 times 2 to the power of 16,998 plus 1.
Right.
That's the biggest one. The biggest one known.
Did he ever find out who she was? Gauss?
Yeah. Later, a mutual friend told him the brilliant young man was a woman. He wrote to her, a taste for the mysteries of numbers is excessively rare. But when a person of the sex, which, according to our customs and prejudices, must encounter infinitely more details than men to familiarize herself with these thorny researches, succeeds nevertheless in penetrating the most obscure parts of them. She must have the noblest courage. Quite extraordinary talents. And superior genius. I memorized it.
I'm sorry, I'm a little drunk.
It's okay. I'm sorry about yesterday. I wasn't helpful. About the work you're doing, take as long as you need upstairs.
No, you were fine. I was pushy.
I was awful.
No, my timing sucked. Anyway, you're probably right.
What?
About it being junk?
Yes.
I read through a lot of stuff today. Just skimming, but except for the book I stole.
Oh, God, I'm sorry about that.
No, it was my fault.
I shouldn't have called the police.
Nah, you were right. Anyway, the point is, that book, I'm starting to think it's the only lucid one, really, and there's no math in it.
No.
I mean, I'll keep looking. I don't come up with anything after a couple of days.
Back to the drums?
Yeah.
And your own research?
Such as it is.
What's wrong with it?
Not exactly setting the world on fire.
Oh, come on.
Nah, it sucks, basically.
Harold?
My papers get turned down, but for the right reasons. My stuff is trivial. The big ideas just aren't there.
It's not about big ideas. It's work. You've got to chip away at a problem.
That's not what your dad did.
I think it was, in a way. He'd attack a question from the side, from some weird angle. Sneak up on it, grind away at it. He was slogging. He was just so much faster than anyone else that from the outside, it looked magical.
I don't know.
I'm just guessing.
Plus, the work was beautiful. You could read it for pleasure. It's streamlined. No wasted moves. It's like a 95 mile an hour fastball. It's just elegant.
Yeah.
And that's what you can never duplicate. At least I can. It's all right. After a while, you realize it's not gonna happen. You readjust your expectations. I enjoy teaching.
You might come up with something.
I'm 28, remember? Downhill slope.
Have you tried speed? I've heard it helps.
Yeah.
So how?
Yeah.
What do you do for sex?
What?
At your conferences. Isn't that why people hold conferences? Room service, travel, tax-deductible sex in big hotel beds.
Maybe? I don't know.
So, what do you do? All you guys.
Well, we are scientists.
So?
So there's a lot of experimentation. I always liked you.
You did?
Yeah. Even before I knew you, I used to catch glimpses of you when you'd come to visit your dad at his office at school. I wanted to talk to you, but I thought, no, you don't flirt with your doctoral advisor's daughter.
Especially when your advisor's crazy.
Yeah, especially then.
You came here once. 4 years ago. Remember?
Yeah. I can't believe you do that. I was dropping off a draft of my thesis for your dad. Jesus, I was nervous.
You looked nervous.
I can't believe you remember that.
I remembered you. I thought you seemed... not boring.
Have you been up?
A while.
Oh, but did I ever sleep?
No.
Is your sister up?
No. She's flying home in a couple of hours. I should probably wake her.
Let her sleep. She's doing some pretty serious drinking with the theoretical physicist.
I'll make her some coffee when she gets up.
Yeah, Sunday mornings, I usually go out, get the paper, have some breakfast.
Okay.
Well, so do you want to come?
I ought to stick around until Claire leaves.
Oh, yeah. All right. Do you mind if I stay?
No, you can work if you want.
Okay.
Okay.
Should I?
If you want to.
You want me to go?
Do you want to go?
I want to stay here with you. I want to spend the day with you. I'd like to spend as much time with you as I can. Unless, of course, I'm coming on way too strong right now. Scaring you, in which case I'll begin back immediately. How embarrassing is it if I say last night was wonderful?
It's only embarrassing if I don't agree.
So?
Don't be embarrassed.
Okay.
find out, Professor.
Now? Okay.
To New York.
Yes, January.
I'd like you to move to New York.
Move?
Would you think about it for me? You can stay with me and Mitch at first, and then you can get your own place. I've already scouted some apartments for you, really cute places.
What would I do in New York?
What are you doing here?
I live here.
You could do whatever you want. You could get a job, you could go to school.
I don't know, Claire, this is pretty major.
I realize that.
I know you mean well. I'm just not sure what I want to do. I mean, to be honest, you were right yesterday. I do feel a little confused. I'm tired. It's been a pretty weird couple of years. I think I'd like to take some time to figure things out.
You could do that in New York.
And I could do it here.
But it would be easier for me to get you set up in an apartment in New York.
I don't need an apartment. I'll stay in the house.
We're selling the house.
What?
I'm selling it.
When?
I'm hoping to do the paperwork this week. I know it seems sudden.
No one was here looking at the place. Who are you selling it to?
The university. They've wanted the block for years.
I live here.
Honey, now that Dad's gone, it doesn't make sense. It's in bad shape. It costs a fortune to heat. It's time to let go. Mitch agrees it's a smart move. We're lucky we have such a great offer.
Where am I supposed to live?
Come to New York.
I don't believe this.
It'll be good for you. You deserve a change. It would be like a whole new adventure for you.
Why are you doing this?
I want to help.
By kicking me out of my...
You were on your own. I really regret that, Katie.
Don't.
I let you down. I feel awful. I want to help.
You want to help now?
Yes.
Dad is dead.
I know.
He's dead! Now that he's dead, you fly in for the weekend and decide you want to help. You're late. Where have you been?
What?
Where were you 5 years ago? You weren't helping then.
I was working.
I was here. I lived with him alone.
I was working 14-hour days. I paid every bill. I paid the mortgage on this house while I lived in a studio in Brooklyn.
You got to have your life. You got to finish school.
You could have stayed in
do what you wanted.
What about Dad? Someone had to look after him.
He was ill. He should have been in a full-time professional care situation.
He didn't belong in a nut house.
He might have been better off.
How can you say that?
This is where I'm supposed to feel guilty, right?
Sure, go for it.
I'm heartless. My own father.
He needed to be here. In his own house, near the university, near his students, near everything that made him happy.
Maybe. Or maybe some real professional care would have done him better than rattling around in this filthy old house with you looking after him. I'm sorry, Catherine. It's not your fault. It's my fault for letting you do it.
I was right to keep him here.
No.
What about his remission? 4 years ago, he was healthy for almost a year.
Then he went right downhill again.
He might have been worse in a hospital.
He might have been better. Did he ever do any work again? No. No. And you might have been better.
Better than what?
Living here with him didn't do you any good. You said so yourself. You had so much talent.
You think I'm like Dad?
I think you have some of his talent and some of his tendencies towards instability.
Claire, in addition to the cute apartments that you've scouted for me in New York, would you, by any chance, also have devoted some of your considerable energy towards scouting out another type of living facility for your bug house little sister?
No, absolutely not. That's not what this is about.
Don't lie to me, Claire. I'm smarter than you.
Resources I've investigated.
Oh, my God.
If you wanted to. All I'm saying is if doctors and the people in New York are the best, if they would be...
Fuck you!
It would be entirely up to you. You wouldn't
have... I hate you!
Don't yell. Please. Calm down.
I hate you.
What are you doing here?
How long have you known about this?
A while.
Why didn't you tell me?
I wasn't sure I wanted to.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
What's going on?
God, Catherine. Thank you.
I thought you'd like to see it.
What is it?
It's incredible.
What is it?
It's a result. That's a proof. At least I think it's a proof. That is a proof. It's a very long proof. I haven't read it all, of course, or checked it. I don't even know if I could check it. But if it is a proof of what I think it's a proof of, it's a very important proof.
What does it prove?
It looks like it proves a theorem. A mathematical theorem about prime numbers. Something mathematicians have been trying to prove, well, since they were mathematicians, basically. Nobody thought it could be done.
Where did you find it?
In your father's study. Catherine told me about it.
You know what this is?
Sure.
Is it good?
Yes!
It's historic. It checks out.
What does it say?
I don't know. I've only read the first few pages.
But what does it mean?
It means that during a time when everybody thought your dad was nuts or barely functioning, he was doing some of the most important mathematics in the world. If it checks out, it means you publish instantly. It means newspapers all around the world are going to want to talk to the person who found this notebook.
Kathy?
Kathy.
I didn't find it.
Yes, you did.
No.
Well, did you find it or did Hal find it?
I didn't find it.
I didn't find it.